So, you know, being director of IIT Kharagpur, which is the first IIT, is really a big responsibility. Now, in order to do this, you need to have three things. You need to dream. That means you need to have your head in the skies. You need to dream really big for an institution like IIT Kharagpur. You need to have your heart with the stakeholders. So you need to know the pulse of every stakeholder. You need to know what the student's heart is like. You need to know what the faculty, the staff, you need to know what the nation wants from you. You need to know what the world looks after you. So your heart must be with all the stakeholders. Your head must be in the sky dreaming about the big things, but your feet must be on the ground. You must know exactly where you are. And then, because this is an engineering institute and being an engineer, I have to develop a plan. So you have to dream, but you have to execute. Execution is at the heart of achieving what you do. You have a limited time frame of 5 years. And every day you have to dream, feel, put your feet on the ground and execute. Yeah, so you have to decide to do it. And once you decide to do it, then you just do it. So one thing I do, if you have noticed, I respond to every email. Anybody has an email, I respond. If I don't respond, means that it is absolutely trash. Even that is one of our philosophers said, even no action is an action. So that is also an action. But in general, I respond to every email, even if it is one word. And I take an action. That is why I try to remain connected. I am not a person who likes to go on to social media. Normally, my private life is very private. But I have gone to social media just to be connected with everybody. Just to tell people what we are doing, what we are thinking, and to hear from people and get feedback. So getting feedback, remaining connected, talking to people, and putting, I sit down and I put myself in your shoes. I put myself in a faculty's shoes. I put myself in a staff's shoes. I put myself in a person who is a parent of a student. And start thinking like them. Only then will I get the solution. It's not that I have to do what they say, but I have to learn to feel what they feel like. I have an advantage that I am of the age, and this is the time when my child was of your age. So I can have a much better understanding of the aspirations of a student. Yeah, so this example I give, like this. This is like cricket. And it is like who your cricketing idol was at that point in time, and what that person looks like is almost identical to a student. See, the wish that I really want to excel remains the same. The want to do fun and enjoy remains the same. But we were like, Sunil Gavaskar, Gundappa, Vishwanath. We will go and, we will make a mark in the world. Y'all are like Virat Kohli. We want to become champs. So that is the difference in the mindset. The difference in the mindset is the difference in the mindset that has come in India itself. Previously, our mindset was, we are good, we will come, we will deliver, we will do what we want. Now the mindset is that we will beat the world. So there is the mindset. The aspirations come from there. And the aspirations become so broad. Our aspirations were like this, narrow aspirations. We knew that we are here and we want to reach here. Therefore, we were reasonably successful in our aspirations. Because we knew we were so good and we will reach here. Now with many more students, it is like this. We have got this way here, this is also here. So, the number of people, relative number of people who will reach here will be less. But you will spread across the spectrum. And because of this aspiration, the people's need from the institution is also different. We really did not bother about infrastructure, food, etc. We were bothered about academics. But now people want to do things in their own hostels. People want to make groups and do new things. People are aware, we had nothing, only one television roaming around. You are connected with the best in the world all the time. So, the aspirations, the requirements have all changed. But the base material is the same. At the heart, the material is the same. The other little bit of difference is, there are a large number of people coming through that coaching syndrome and unlearning and getting to your feet in many cases takes a little more of time. We just came happy-go-lucky and got into the institute, so we didn't even know what to expect. You all know everything, kya hai, kya department hai, this, that, you know. So we were very happy-go-lucky. The change in the mindset of students has got three or four reasons. We came from large joint families where we were brought up together and we lived a different life. My father even didn't bother, never came actually. Never came. My mother came only once in convocation. They used to only ask me, so, everything is all right? I said, everything is all right. My uncle, auntie used to figure out, so, you all come from presently unitized families. Your parents know more about JE than you. So that whole mindset, the pressure on the student, the world's aspiration of the student, over a period of last 30-40 years, the expectation from an IITian and IITian's expectation from themselves have all changed. So that brings a different dimension. It brings both a higher aspiration, it brings a pressure, and it makes you amenable to this world. The first plan was to improve the quality of the academic curriculum. And our academic curriculum was straitjacketed. You know, people come into this institute, when they come, they really don't know why they have come to what department. As they grow over a period of time, they want to move. So, bringing flexibility into the academic curriculum and bringing a quality into the academic curriculum, bringing some diligence of a minimum quality with the flexibility that we have. And as we have grown to large size classes, doing something about it was my first priority. That is why the few things that we brought in immediately were this concept of micro-specializations. This was something I said that we must bring in so as to enable people to learn things that will make them much more employable or more amenable to research. A student who has joined, let us say, metallurgy engineering may still be interested in photonics. And there is this huge talent. So this was my first thing. The second thing was to be able to bring in more and more courses and faculty from outside. So that is why we started the International Summer Winter Program. The third thing was is to be able to embed and change the curriculum where student outcomes will be more important than just an examination result. This is where we have come up with the idea, but we have not yet executed that idea yet. That idea needs to be executed. And in order to improve the students' curricular structure, the next thing was the academic infrastructure. That means we really needed to change some of our laboratories. And in this institution, undergraduate labs, research facilities are the two categories. Research, we have put in huge amount of investment and brought in much more change in research. But in the undergraduate lab facilities, in some departments have done it, but some departments, in spite of our attempts to make them do it, have not done it. But over the next 1 year, some of our things will get rolled out. The first year labs, etc., all will get rolled out. And we are now planning in the... So as you asked, you know, what have we done here? Here I can say I've been 50% successful. At least the students have some flexibility in moving around. But we still have scope for improving the quality of the program in terms of enriching the student outcome. The outcome is still on exams. The outcome should be on getting them to produce results, which they can do even at this level. And for that, we really have to nurture more people, and we really have to bring some more changes in the curriculum. Wherever they have brought in these in some of the courses and some of the teachers, and just outstanding results are coming up. Then we have to do some more types of programs, which we are trying to change the structure of doing projects. We have now introduced semester away program. So getting the students more experience on other things, just not that classroom experience. The classroom experience is about 1/4 of the total experience that is required academically. Classroom experience, own work experience, experience of the outside world, and the international best experience. These four combinations and the flexibility, you know, eventually I want, it doesn't matter which department you get into, it matters what you get out with. So that is how we are trying to bring in that change. We are about halfway through in what we have attempted. So this is the first plan. The second plan is about infrastructure. So the first thing we did was to make Nalanda complex air conditioned. Classrooms, exam halls, the first year when I went around to see students giving exams and having classes, I thought that this just cannot go on. So we had to retrofit. You have no idea that the building was not designed that way. To retrofit the whole Nalanda complex to make it air conditioned. We are now making several new buildings and infrastructures so that we have all modern complexes. So that is where I think we have made some improvement in terms of infrastructure. In terms of research infrastructure, we have done. My main other project, which we will execute, which I hope the institute will execute with the in the coming years, is we will build another state-of-the-art teaching laboratory complex, which will be like Nalanda, a full building where all modern teaching labs will be there. Then we wanted to get state-of-the-art compute facility. So our supercomputing facility is going to come. The CRF, the Central Research Facility, has been augmented and will be more augmented. So these are the few things we wanted to do in terms of academic infrastructure. The other thing I wanted to improve was infrastructure on the campus, hostel infrastructure. There were two approaches. One is to make new hostels. So we got the Nivedita done. And we are going to do 4 more hostels now. And But I wanted to improve the quality of the current hostels. That is why we started the room renovation program. And it stopped midway. So it stopped some due to our issues, some due to issues at student end. But that is another program. So our two programs is that we have to build new amenities and infrastructure. And that has to be state of the art. You cannot have the same infrastructure as we had before. So that is where, you know, in individual hostels, the new hostels, the other things that we probably should not have done is to make hostels of size 1600, 1800 capacity. Hostels are of 500 capacity. That is the, then you know everybody. So the hostel infrastructure, the new hostels we have built, we are going to build, for example, the next hostels that we are going to build are all going to be air-conditioned hostels. Because now we want to have the students, you know, life has changed. And if we want to bring in the best quality ambience for them to do things, it's not that we don't want them to struggle. We want them to struggle academically. But, you know, we really want that this becomes a modern institution. So here we still have a long way to go in improving the quality of the older hostels and rolling out the programs which are related to the room renovation programs and things like that. I got a lot of funding. So we are also going to build a new girls hostel. We are going to build a new international hostel. We are building an international visitors complex next to this guest house. We are going to build another girls hostel. We are going to build a complete outreach where that hostel itself will have conference room, auditorium and everything else. That is why in the new hostels I've said elevators and lifts, all new hostels will automatically have. They said no, up to fourth floor. I said doesn't matter. These are things that are required. So while we are painting the hostels, etc., etc., when I came in, that there was this huge jump where a lot of students were doubled up. It was an X by Y. If the room capacity is X, the number of students staying in that room was Y, where Y is greater than X. And then there were rooms which are triple seaters. I did not think that it is worthwhile to have. We did that in a hurry at some point in time earlier. But the way we are now going to build our infrastructure and renovate it, I really don't think we want that X by X. So getting to X by X was an issue. But we've got there now. But the quality of infrastructure, especially the ladies' hostels, they are still cramped and we need to build more ladies' hostels. We got one made, but we still need to do more. So here, I would say that I am about 30-40% in the hostel infrastructure. But in the academic research and the other infrastructure, we've done about 70% of what we wanted to do. The third thing is about making ourselves do programs that impact the nation and the world. Kharagpur is not in the sight of everybody. So we have to run things and do such things that makes everybody look at IIT Kharagpur and say, oh, IIT Kharagpur is doing this. So today we run the Global Initiative of Academic Networks, which brings all international faculty all over the country into other institutes of the country. Everybody knows IIT Kharagpur does it. We run the National Digital Library of India. The whole world now knows that this is what is happening. Our students are now participating. So the other thing I wanted to do is make sure there is flexibility in our students to go to all the best places in the world. So that is why I initiated this top conferences. It is a bottomless pit, you know. We identified 300 top conferences, and if a student has a paper there, we will fund it. So all students, so huge. The expenditure which was aimed at 1 crore per year, today has reached 6 crores per year. Can you imagine? We spend 6 crores per year in making our students go to international conferences. Then we worked with alumni to set up the Rajgarhia International Program. So for students to participate, because of the talent, we can really start changing and beating. So here, in making ourselves go international, making the world look at IIT Kharagpur, I think we've done a really good job. We've done a really good job. And today, people recognize that IIT Kharagpur, you know, the first thing, it is far away, but once they start interacting with us, it has happened always and always that our people, whether it's students or faculty or staff, have always performed much better. So the recognition now is that the value add that IIT Kharagpur gives to its students is more than any other institution. So that is our USP now. You come here, the value add is much better.